Since the pandemic, we have seen a lot of things in short supply, from toilet paper to lumber, even hot sauce. Now a beer shortage could be a brewin. Local breweries are paying more to get the gas they need to keep the taps foamy. We told you yesterday, a carbon dioxide shortage is creating some nationwide problems. NBC2's Sarah Metz found out if we're feeling the effects here.
Local brewery owners tell me the shortage wouldn't just affect them. It's actually any place with a tap or a soda machine that needs CO2.
There was only one time that we were without CO2, and it was only for a week so far.
Flat pours and closed doors, the two worst things these breweries would face with a shortage.
At this point, locally, we haven't felt a shortage. We've been very lucky in that respect.
In our case, they're doing a great job at making sure that we've been supplied. So,
for local breweries, CO2 is needed in production.
We use CO2 to carbonate the kegs and also the cans.
And of course, pouring the perfect pint.
CO2 is a critical part of what we do and how we make the beer.
Without it, it's crafting chaos.
There isn't much you can do.
Local spots rely on CO2 deliveries from outside companies.
The supply problem isn't specific to one provider. It's a nationwide challenge.
So if they're running low, it could slow the flow.
But a carbon dioxide shortage is something that is hard to mitigate against.
For us, it's definitely a scary situation, because if we make that call and if they say, hey, we're out and we're not going to have any for a month, then we have to go into scramble mode.
The only effect our local breweries are feeling from the shortage.
We have had our pricing go up about double.
The cost of CO2 in the last year has gone up 250%.
For you, it's nothing to worry about or stock up on, but it is something to keep in mind.
As of right now, I don't see it being a major emergency, but honestly, it's hard to say because that could change at any moment.
Reporting in Fort Myers, Sarah Metz, NBC2.